thing we've ever played in our lives. We have come such a long way since 2004. And you guys have too. Trust me, we saw your hair in 2004. We saw your MySpace profiles. And now everybody looks chill and fancy. You look like adults, like you got real jobs and stuff. Put money in your 401k. It's looking chill. Anyway, great to see you guys tonight. We are Hawthorne Heights. Behind us are the Emo Orchestra. We're going to get to the game here with you guys. Some of you have probably never heard of emo music whatsoever. You're probably glad you're going to see a recital tonight. Buckle up. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to play some of our favorite songs by bands that we absolutely love, some that we're friends with, some that we're just fans of, and we're all just going to have a great time. Usually when we play this setting, or when we come to shows in this theater, it's more of a chill, relax, be quiet, let this stuff happen. But tonight, we want everybody singing from the top of your lungs. Sing along. These songs are built for you guys, your youth, your childhood, and we just want to have a lot of fun with you guys tonight, okay? Thank you guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
who has raised this generation of emo, who all fell in love with these songs. So it's on the entire audience to keep these songs alive. And that's what we're doing here tonight, is just giving you a different version of how these things play out and how it doesn't really matter your musical skill or talent or anything. It's about that reaction and that emotion that these lyrics and the music we add, these wonderful layers on top of it. It's almost just all of these moments aren't really lost on us. As we look out, we see your faces. That's all we've ever wanted. And it really is, it's just a culmination of the hard work of the last 20 years that all of these people up here have heard and all the people out there. You guys have all made it through the worst times of your lives because of a lot of these songs. And I think we're really happy. Literally living the best part of your lives right now. It's kind of weird to like be in a band and try to find music that moves you, because like anything else, like you guys probably don't want to do your job and you don't want to do your job. So we also have to find songs that move us in different ways. And the song that we're going to play right now, the first time that I heard this song, it just immediately made me think of the most special person in my life and how it says every word that I say to that person without saying a single word. So, if you have somebody you've been with for a long time, you know that you're building a long haul, you can't imagine who you're going to be without them. Think about this song, because that's what this song means to me. I hope you guys like it, right? That's one of the reasons that we chose it.
Thank you. Half frequencies.
Anyway, thank you guys so much for just listening to this. And I know a lot of you guys probably saw what we announced and said this, which made you excited. But we're here for the people who kind of came to this site unseen and had no idea what we're doing. So, who knows the emo Christmas morning, folks? So we're going to do a song right now. One of our favorite bands, definitely a very influential band for all of us, probably when we first started touring in like the early 2000s. This is a band that we just wore out in the tour of that. And we're just driving over 9 or 12 hours trying to figure out how to play for the band for the first time. This is a band that absolutely inspired us, still inspires us to this day. We're releasing new music again, and I'm so excited about it. The songs are actually bangers, but we're going to play one of our favorite songs, which is probably the most difficult song in the set because of how incredible the band is and how just charismatic the singer is. It's full of vibe, and that's hard to do, but we're going to give it our best shot. This is one of our favorite songs. We hope you guys love it.
You want everything.
Dad's upset.
Yeah, thank you guys so much. Like I said, a lot of these people are our friends, and that's why these songs are so special to us as well. So we got to hear them as kids and grow up with these people, and it's just really, really special. So we're going to play a song right now. We've been on tour with this band multiple times, and they are just absolute wonderful people and insane musicians, and they make us laugh so much. So we could not tell them that we were playing this song until they found out we were playing this song. It was a hilarious conversation. But we're going to keep that to ourselves because that's a lot of cussing. And while we're punk and while we're emo, this is opulent and reverse of who we are as people. We're still going to keep it semi-classic. All right. Thank you. This one goes out to our boys from St. Louis.
Yeah! Yeah.
Peace.
Yeah!
So, this is the set of National Surprises. We have you guys sing along to some of our favorite songs. The anthem for the genre, Welcome to Black Parade. And that's one of our favorite parts of the set because they take time off. Me, we get to sit back, listen to these wonderful musicians, and this is
Dads of Sad.
Thank you.
you guys can make these songs. A song that we're playing right now is single-handedly one of the main reasons that Hawthorne Heights is here. And that is because before we were just a local band, just playing kind of pop music, and because there was a blueprint that would become the emo extremo genre, it did not really exist yet. So when this band came out, all of us immediately went, holy shit. You can do that? Why are we wasting our time looking for one thing? We can sing, scream, and show all the passion, all the aggression that we possibly could. And I just think that this song is a similar moment in our band specifically. I don't remember the first time seeing any of this scene.
Thank you.
Play it again.
Being in a band is about all your life.
Shit, yeah. Thank you. Dads of Sad!
We have hours to just talk about. give a big round of applause to the show's producer, the person who came up with this whole idea, sat us down and said, I want to take 7 weeks of your lives and make you extremely nervous and uncomfortable. And we said yes.
You're beautiful.
I'm trying to help you.